Kia ora koutou, atamare ai, miri, kiri miti. Welcome to this service for the third Sunday of Advent. While the theme is joy, it is also a family service, and we have many contributors today. We also continue our CWS Christmas appeal, and the focus today is the cry for COVID justice. In Uganda, COVID-19 has caused great harm. The official COVID death toll would be much higher if more people had been tested. Medical centres are unprepared, and the promise of the people's vaccine far distant. Schools have been closed for the last 18 months and incomes have fallen. But there has been joy in the Southwest, where the Centre for Community Solidarity has organised rainwater tanks, distributed face masks made by young women, and taught the HIV and AIDS caregivers how to protect themselves and their communities. Grandmother Sikora says her tank was a blessing from God. We seek COVID justice. Enjoy this family service. Enter into worship. Let there be joy in our coming together this morning. Let there be truth heard in the words we speak and the songs we sing. Let there be help and healing for disharmony and despair. And let there be silence for the voice within us and beyond us. Let there be joy in our coming together. We light the candle of joy. Over the last two Sundays, we have lit the candle of hope and the candle of peace. Today we light the third candle of Advent. For those who have joy in their hearts, for those whose lives are full of difficulty, for those who are anxious and have no peace, we light the candle of joy. We remember also the voice of God's messengers calling us to be bearers of joy in a troubled world. We light the candle of joy for all who deliver good news at the gathering places, by elderly prophets and by angels, by neighbours, by astrologers, shepherds, by shopkeepers, women at the well, by gossip. The good news was spread at Christmas. We light this candle of joy at the good news of God's coming among us. Amen. Psalm 98. Make a joyful noise, all the earth. Break forth into grateful song and sing praises. Yes, sing songs of praise, extolling love's way. Lift up your hearts with gratitude and joy. Let the voices of the people blend in harmony, in unison. Let the people magnify the beloved. Let the sea laugh and all that fills it, the world and those who dwell in it. Let the waters clap their hands, let the hills ring out with joy before the beloved who radiates love for all the earth. For love reigns over the world with truth and justice, bringing order and balance to all of creation. Amen.
Kia ora te whānau, this is a message for you all, but especially for the young and the young at heart. How are you all? I hope you're well and this week has been good to you all. This week's focus is joy, and I'm excited about this week's service. This is probably my favourite service of the whole year. Joy. I love it. Now, we might not be meeting in person today, but that's okay. We can still celebrate joy from the comfort of our own living rooms, perhaps even with a warm cup of coffee in your hands or a sweet treat for morning tea by your side. You see, it's joyful already. And I love the build-up to Christmas, old traditions like singing Christmas carols, and new traditions like, for us, buying a new decoration for the tree each year. I wonder what brings you joy at Christmas. Today I'm going to step aside and let the families, the children and the youth of our parish share the joy of Christmas with you. Enjoy. Wishing you all a joyful Christmas, Aroha Nui, and God bless.
Remember, God bless us all. cookies are sweet like love. They are delicious. They are yummy. Chocolate chip cookies. Gingerbread cookies. They are delicious. Like love. They're so beautiful, love, and stars are leading the way to Jesus, baby.
Christmas. Every time a hand reaches out to help another person, that is Christmas. Every time someone puts anger aside and strives for understanding, that is Christmas. Every time people forget their differences and realize their love for one another, that is Christmas. May this Christmas bring us closer to the spirit of human understanding and closer to the blessing of peace.
This is a song that I learned from my nanny called Christmas Alphabet, and I'm going to sing it to you now. C is for the candy trims around the Christmas tree. H is for the happiness for all the family. R is for the reindeer prancing by the window pane. I is for the icing on the cake of sweet sugar cane. S is for the stocking on the chimney wall. T is for the toys beneath the tree so tall. M is for the mistletoe where everyone is kissed. A is for the angels who make up the Christmas list. S is for old Santa who makes every kid his pet. Be good if he'll give you everything in the Christmas alphabet.
I declare Al free with zero charges against him.
Walking in a winter wonderland.
praise the Lord, cause Christmas time is here. God knows the world and our fraction of the laws. So all it is just the sun time, just because it's Christmas time.
a time of reflection, the moment of magic. Now is the moment of magic, when the whole round world earth sits warm under a summer sun, and he is a blessing. The days are longer and brighter now. Now is the moment of magic, when people beaten down and broken, with nothing left but misery and candles, and their own clear voice, kindle tiny light and whisper secret music, and he is a blessing. The universe is suddenly illuminated by the light of Christmas, and the whole world is glad and loud with summer singing. Now is the moment of magic, when an eastern star beckons the blazing sunset to linger a little longer, and he is a blessing. They find nothing in the end but an ordinary baby, born at midnight, born in poverty, and the baby's cry, like bells ringing, makes people wonder as they wander through their lives. What human love might really look like, sound like, feel like. Now is the moment of magic, and he is a blessing. We already possess all the gifts we need. We have already received our presents. Ears to hear the music, eyes to behold light, hands to build true peace on earth, and to hold each other tight in love.
Prayer of Awareness. It may seem naive, in a world of grief, to choose to live in joy. It may seem foolish, in a world where solemnity is power, to sing and dance to a different tune. It may seem cruel, in a world of suffering and injustice, to speak of light and celebration. But you have come, Jesus, to bring joy into our grief, light into our darkness, singing into our mourning, and it is an act of healing and proclamation, to believe and embrace the joy you offer. Joy to the world. The Lord has come. Hallelujah. Amen.
Joy for and triumph. The very first Christmas was long, long ago. A girl called Mary had started to grow. Inside she carried a wee baby boy, and an angel was sent to tell of the joy.
Angel on the rocket.
That's not in the story. Angels don't need rockets.
Mary was speechless. She didn't know how these things could have happened, but still she bowed. The angel then made an appearance to Joe, who was worried when Mary had started to show. But Gabriel said, "You may find this odd. Just trust me. These things are all coming from God. Mary is carrying God's only son, the saviour of old, the long promised one. So call his name Jesus, your maker in skin. He's come now to save all his people from sin." Meanwhile, great Caesar Augustus in Rome had made a decree, "Return to your home." For Joseph, this ruling meant Bethlehem town. So they rode on their donkey all the way down.
Dad, coming to your hand.
What are you doing? She said they were riding on a donkey, not a helicopter.
Fine, that's better.
That's not in the story.
Arriving in Bethlehem, Mary was blooming. But try as they might, no hotels had room in. They asked one innkeeper, "Sir, are you able?" The innkeeper said, "Oh, go on, use my stable." So Jesus was born in a cold cattle shed, with nowhere to lay him. A trough was his bed.
Wait, what? That can't be in the story.
Actually, it is. Listen.
Now out in the fields, some angels appeared to shepherds who cowered and all of them feared. One angel said, "Peace, I bring you good news. The Saviour is born, so put on your shoes." The shepherds all hurried to old Bethlehem to worship the baby who'd been born for them. Away in the east, there lived some wise men who followed a star wherever it went. They knew it would lead them to worship the king. So gold, incense and myrrh they did bring.
It's getting crowded now.
Do you think there's room?
Now here around the baby, the world is invited. The strongest and weakest, they all are united. From wise men to shepherds, from angels to sheep. From shiniest heights to the darkest deep. So come to the manger, see God become small. The true Christmas story has room for us all.
It's bigger than you thought.
Maybe it is in the story.
Isaiah chapter 12, verses 2 to 6. God is indeed my salvation. I will trust and won't be afraid. Yah, the Lord is my strength and my shield. He has become my salvation. You will draw water with joy from the springs of salvation, and you will say on that day, "Thank the Lord, call on God's name, proclaim God's deeds among the peoples, declare that God's name is exalted. Sing to the Lord who has done glorious things. Proclaim this throughout all the earth. Shout and sing for joy, city of Zion, because the Holy One of Israel is great among you." Amen.
Reading Philippians chapter 4, verses 4 to 7. Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I say, rejoice. The Lord is near. Do not worry about anything, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving. Let your requests be made known to God, and the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus.
Joy seems to come from within. It is not tied to events things or circumstances, like landing a new job or buying a new car or celebrating a birthday. Joy is more like an attitude. It comes from a spiritual place, no matter what your spiritual belief might be. It comes from inner contentedness and worthiness. From feeling connected to self and others, joy is present regardless of circumstances. We cannot wait for circumstances to bring us joy. We must make our own joy and let it act upon circumstances. Any problem or trouble can be overcome by the power of joy. Some overcomings take a little longer than others, but even if we are dealing with a problem of long standing, that is no reason to despair or give up hope of solving new problems that come along. But how do we cultivate joy in the heart, more joy in our lives? If we want more joy, we must use joy. We must lay hold on joy and let it well up from within us through thought, word, and action. In the river, the water continually flows on, yet the river is ever there. Thank you.
Response, Psalm 126. When the God's love entered the human heart, all yearning are fulfilled. Then with our mouths ring forth with laughter, and our tongues with shouts of joy, then we will sing our songs of praise to you, O beloved of our hearts. For gladness will radiate out of all to see, so great is your presence among us. Restore us to wholeness, O healer, like newborn babies who have never strayed from you. May all who sow in tears reap with shouts of joy. May all who go forth weeping tears of repentance, bearing seeds of love, come home to you with shouts of joy, leaving sorrow behind.
Poem, True Joy. I'll be happy once I've done this certain thing. We all say this often, not realizing what it brings. We look only to the future for our happiness, letting life slip through our fingers in its fullness. We really feel complete when the task is done, or look back and see how we missed so much fun. Self-consumed, so we can't see anything else, hurting those we love as well as ourselves. So many things around us to be grateful for, when seeking for an answer, willingly opening the door. So often, others see what is in front of our face, but we're too blind to look as if we're snared in the race. What is this life supposed to be about? Is it money, fortune, fame, or a big house? When speaking to a man on his dying bed, none of these answers are what he said. Family, love, laughter are what we should seek. These are the precious things that keep life from being bleak.
Thank you. Kia ora koutou, Malawilele. I'm Murray from Christian World Service, CWS. In this third week of Advent, as we look to the coming of Christ, we raise the third of our cries for justice, a new kind of justice denied to the most vulnerable people in our world, COVID justice. In Uganda, COVID-19 has caused great harm. No one can be certain of COVID rates and deaths, God alone knows, but only 1% are vaccinated. Schools have been closed for the last 18 months and low incomes have fallen even further. But there has been joy in the Southwest. Our partner, your partner, the Centre for Community Solidarity run by Charles, has organised rainwater tanks, distributed face masks made by young women, and they have taught the caregivers of HIV and AIDS-affected children how to protect themselves from coronavirus. Grandmother Sakura says her rainwater tank is a blessing from God, accompanied by music, dancing, celebration, and great joy. For the children, no more 7-kilometre walk every day for diseased river water. Thank you for seeking COVID justice with us, for those who are most vulnerable in this pandemic. As Isaiah 1:17 says, seek justice, rescue the oppressed, defend the orphan, plead for the widow. Your gifts to this year's Christmas appeal and prayers in action for people who have so little defence against COVID can bring joy and justice this Christmas. Ngā mihi nui for working with CWS and through us for justice around the world. Let's rejoice and worship God, our God of joy.
Our final Christmas carol for today is Joy to the World. And of course, you can sing along, but also please get up, get on your feet and dance. Please dance to the actions on the screen. Enjoy.
Words of mission, holy love that swirls within us and around us, that holds us together in each and every moment, we thank you for the moments of pure joy, for the sweet nectar of life beyond the comfort zone. May we lean on you with trust and adoration when we lean into life, and may our hearts fill with the gifts that brave and vulnerable action bring forth. Blessed be.
May we never rest until every child of earth in every generation is free from all prisons of the mind, of the body, and of the spirit. Until the earth and the hills and the seas shall dance, let us love one another and the earth, for as a body is animated through the relationships among its many parts, so God is made manifest among us through our love. Remember your promise. Live in hope. Go in peace.
Thank you.